This is Kneon. I am not here with Geeky Sparkles in this video. We're going to talk about the comic book industry because we have to talk about the comic book industry. I've been putting off doing this video for about a week now. And it's because, honestly, comic book industry news doesn't really interest me anymore. It's all doom and gloom. I mean, it really is. For the most part, the mainstream comic book industry, I'm talking the direct market, I'm talking Marvel, DC, I'm talking comic shops, everything that we've known for the last like 30, 40 years. That scene is crumbling. You can't deny it anymore. And now people that, you know, disagreed with YouTubers who were calling this out, you know, years ago, are finally coming around to me like, yeah, the comic book scene's collapsing, guys. What do we do? And I'm like, you don't do anything. You close your eyes and you wait for the end to come, because at this point, there's nothing you can do. There's nothing you can do to save the direct market. It's over. Now, that being said, I want to be clear. Manga's fine. Graphic novels are fine. People selling direct to consumer, fine. Crowdfunding for some people, fine. So comics as an art form is fine, and there are people making money in comics. That's fine. But the direct market, where the majority of American comics are sold, distributed, that whole scene is collapsing. And I think there were people that were so obsessed with owning the chuds for the last 4 or 5 years that they weren't paying attention to everything crumbling around them. And it's shocking how willfully blind these people have been, including journalist Heidi McDonald. She basically got called out. Well, we'll talk about this. I mean, this isn't the whole point of the video, but just like these comic book journalists that were, you know, 10, 15 years ago would have been sounding the alarms are now standing. I can't think of a better word, standing for the remnants, the fragments of the direct market that's still left. You know, they're just like finding every damn reason to say, no, this is fine, just to be contrary, when all of the evidence points to the opposite being true. And you don't have to like YouTubers. You don't have to like certain YouTubers. You don't have to agree with everything they're saying, but the numbers don't lie. You know, Heidi, Rich, all you other comic book journos, the numbers don't lie. The numbers are bad. There are shops that have been around for decades closing at an alarming rate. Sales are down. The majority of freelancers are broke. And everything is just kind of collapsing. And you know what? You're not going to have anything to cover. It is in your best interests to try to figure out why the comic book industry is collapsing and try to stop the bleeding, because people aren't even interested in comic book news. They're not even interested in comic book YouTube anymore. In fact, yesterday, Comicstorian, one of the biggest comic book YouTube channels out there, posted a video that he's basically going to have to pivot his content because there's not enough interest in comic book videos anymore. Because the mainstream industry is just, it's dead, guys. It's dead. And people are like, no, that's not true. I've got a comic shop in my town. Well, good for you. But you know what? Some of these shops have been around for decades in California and New York. And now we're talking Florida. They're going out of business. Jim Hanley's Universe? I mean, what's it going to take? I mean, Midtown going out for you guys to get it through your heads? It's over. It is over. And the corporate owners of Marvel and DC don't care about comic books that much. They really don't. To them, it's ancillary merchandise. It's no different than t-shirts, except it actually, and I've heard this from the horse's mouth, I've heard it from somebody at Disney Publishing, it costs more to produce comic books, a hell of a lot more to produce comic books than it does to produce t-shirts. You can just pay somebody to draw Spider-Man once and sell it on a t-shirt for the next 20 years versus paying somebody to draw a Spider-Man comic book. You know, and all the stuff that's being produced in Hollywood, that was the excuse for, oh, we need comic books because Hollywood's got a strip mine and stuff. They don't need you. In fact, the smartest, brightest, most talented comic book writers are going directly to Hollywood. They don't need to make a pit stop in the comic book industry, slum it in the comic book industry. They can just go to Hollywood and write comic book stories. And it doesn't matter anyway. I mean, they're taking so many liberties with these movies now that doesn't really matter. They're not basing them on the comic books. They're basing them very, very, very loosely on the comic books and just making the rest of it up. So we're going to talk about this a little bit more. I'm just going to kind of roll all of this comic book news into one video, because it's not even worth covering in multiple videos. There's not enough interest Ask Comicstorian. Ask anybody who has covered mostly comic books on YouTube for the last couple of years. There's not even enough interest, enough give a shit in the American comic book industry, in the market right now, to be able to cover it and make money off of it. Like, nobody cares. And I was watching this guy's video, and I don't know him. I know he does like mostly like voiceovers for comics and stuff like that. His channel's got almost 3 million subs, right? So he had to be doing something right. But he even said, like, when the DC movies were doing well and the Marvel movies were doing well, he said, I saw all kinds of interest, all kinds of views on my channel. But now that even the movies, people are even losing interest in the movies, it's over. Like, I got to do something else, you know? And I've seen so many comic book channels or comic book based channels since we started. We really started hitting YouTube pretty hard like 5 or 6 years ago. And there are so many that either they stopped doing it or they pivoted their content, or they're just kind of, you know, coasting on fumes now because people can't even muster up enough give a shit to get angry about the comic book industry anymore. That's where we are. I mean, that's where we're at. Like, apathy is the worst. When people are angry about comics, that's because they actually thought there was a chance that Marvel and DC would pull their heads out of their asses and turn things around. And retailers are hoping that that will be the case. But we're gonna look at an article here that's making the rounds. It's not the case. Marvel and DC are not going to course correct. There's no course to correct. Mark Miller has some good ideas, some great ideas about what it would take to save comics. But you're assuming that the corporate owners of those companies actually want to save the comic book industry. They don't care. And that they don't care, and the readers don't care. It's obvious they don't care. They're just letting crazy Tumblr shippers run rampant with intellectual property, because it doesn't matter. At the end of the day, it doesn't matter to Warner Brothers. It doesn't matter to Disney, because they're not going to adhere to any of that stuff when they eventually get around to making, you know, TV shows or movies or cartoon shows or whatever. They're just going to cherry pick the stuff they like and retcon and re-retcon and reboot and re-reboot and all of that. None of it matters anymore. So let's talk about all of this before we get into it any further. Please, yeah, we're into it pretty far. Before we get into it any further, please subscribe for more pop culture news, views, and rants, guys. Go out to shopclownfish.com / Shadowbinders Volume 3 graphic novel hardcover, first new Shadowbinders content in 10 years. You can still pick up book 1 and 2. We still have some of those left. You got a little over a week. And yeah, we're definitely going to hit our goal on this. These are not going to ship until next year, by the way. And look, we walked away from the comic book industry in 2015. I did a lot of freelancing in comics. We did web comics. And it became very obvious back then that this industry was headed for an iceberg. It's like, there is no future in this. Even if you get a publishing deal, if you do graphic novels and you get a deal with like Scholastic or something like that, the amounts of money you're talking about are very, very small for most people. Every once in a while, you're going to get a Dave Pilkey, you're going to get a Dogman, you're going to get a Raina Telgemeier. But for most people, the amounts of money are not great. In fact, our former agent told me that we were looking at maybe a $35,000 to $50,000 advance on like 3 books. And we had to live on that for how many years? I'm like, that is not good money. I'm sorry. And then you don't get any more money until you pay back the money that the publisher advanced you. And then you have to give your agent like 10 to 20%. And then you got to pay taxes. You know what I'm saying? Like, it adds up. The money's not there. And again, every once in a while, and everybody points to the Michael Jordans, the big superstars in comics, being like, look, guys, this is a totally viable career. I'm like, how many thousands of people work in the industry? And there's like, I think probably 2 hands, you can count the number of people that are making what I would consider to be fantastic money across the spectrum, you know, whether it's, you know, Scholastic or working, you know, one of the top shelf Marvel DC artists or crowdfunding or whatever it is. You don't have a lot of people statistically. You're talking like less than 1%. Less than 1% of people working in the comic book industry are making great money. Retirement, you know, the kind of money that you can retire on. You know, I worked for a couple of years and I never have to work again, right? Just like not everybody from the 90s was making Todd McFarlane or Rob Liefeld money. So speaking of money, let's talk about this article coming from ICV2, Comic Stores in 2023. It's nearly 2024 and I'm more than concerned. This is a Phil Boyle of Coliseum of Comics, which is a franchise in Florida. It's one of the largest comics and games retailers in the Southeast. Okay, just I want to reiterate, this is one of the largest, this is the owner of one of the largest retailers, or is the largest comics and game retailer in the Southeast. He's sharing his concerns and suggested solutions for comic stores. I also want to point out that Jeffrey's Comics, the oldest comic shop, I guess, in LA. Is that what it was? Yeah, LA's oldest comic shop shut down. This is after Meltdown shut down a couple of years ago. I know that the comic shop, one of the comic shops I used to go to, God, bounding into comics. Guys, you got to put your header up here because I got to kind of like read behind the thing here. The comic shop behind Free Comic Book Day said it might be shutting down. It's Flying Colors. We've got Jim Hanley's Universe going out of business in Manhattan. You know, what is it going to fucking take? I mean, seriously, what is it going to take? IDW, did they shut their building down? Did they not shut their offices down? Who the hell knows? Dark Horse noped out. They sold to Embracer Group, but Embracer Group is laying people off like crazy. It's like it's all imploding. What is it going to take? And then you've got journalists like Heidi McDonald, who used to be legit. I don't know what happened to her in the last couple of years. I think her brain's been pickled by politics or some shit, or she's listening to the Tumblr Twitterati and not listening to common sense anymore, because she used to be legit. You know, she used to be one of the most legit journalists out there. But like the truth is staring you in the face, and she finds every damn reason to sidestep around it because she doesn't want to make her friends feel bad. Your friends need to feel bad because your friends probably caused this, Heidi. Like, seriously, you've been around a long time. You've seen everything and you know things are not good. Why are you lying? Why are you lying? Things are not good. She goes to Jim Hanley's Universe as they're closing down and is trying to get them to basically own the Chuds, you know, and now she's out there trying to say that this comic shop was garbage and that's why they're going out of business. I'm like, what the hell? And she gets called out for it too. So yeah, this is the guy who's in charge of the largest franchise of comic shops in the Southeast. Marvel and DC, you blew it. Or maybe you just succeeded in your plan to kill off an American art form of which you've been able to be the stewards of for 80 years. It's baffling that something so prolific was ushered to the chopping block and executed. Strong accusations, no, just the unvarnished truth as new comic sales find new lows. That's true. The shops that are doing well are selling games. They're selling back issues. They're selling pop culture knickknacks. They're selling vinyl pops or Funko pops. But that's even drying up. He says, even worse, you've gutted an army of passionate retailers who have worked in this business for decades for close to poverty wages in many cases. To put such a system of advocates in every state and major city in America and around much of the world would cost a fortune, but happened organically to your benefit. And in gratitude, you strip mined what little profit there was in favor of short-term goals and chasing corporate bonuses. I don't know how many bonuses they're actually getting. I'm going to be honest. We, the retailers, cultivated the fan base the same way the underappreciated creators created the precious IPs that made their parent companies obscene amounts of money. It was a biosystem of fans feeding off the Wednesday excitement, eager to spend money on not only the comics that drew them in, but t-shirts, lunchboxes, mouse pads, etc., etc. Where'd it go off the rails? It's not such a conundrum to anyone with two active brain cells, which apparently Heidi McDonald's lacks, and a list of back issues they need to complete their runs. Comics, first and foremost, have always been entertainment, collectible entertainment, but he's talking about character swapping, gender bending, changing sexual orientation of beloved characters, fell flat with Wednesday Warriors who supported the industry for decades. The crowd of new readers the changes were meant to attract didn't translate for a one-to-one swap, leaving a declining customer base. To make things more difficult on the retail side, in a very deliberate abuse of both the FOC system and retailers' goodwill toward publishers, we constantly have to FOC an issue, two issues out rather than the next issue. It makes ordering a guess. They're talking variant cover schemes, et cetera, et cetera. This is what his recommendation is to fix it. It's too late, guys. It's way too late. It's over. It's done with. It would take a top to bottom restructuring of the comic book industry. It would take a fundamental seismic shift like the introduction of the direct market to salvage the direct market. And I just don't see that happening. $3.99 comics, I'd say $2.99, but you know, with rent and labor and stuff. $4.99 and more as a non-starter. Fewer covers. editors who are editors. Too many stories are lackluster and agenda-driven. Too many covers are con-sketch drivel with no sales point, and too much interior art is amateurish. It's clear neither Marvel or DC has a publishing plan beyond the current reboot. They don't care. Again, I've heard this directly from Disney Publishing, that the comic books are just viewed as ancillary merchandise. They don't care. The characters are iconic for a reason. The movies never got traction until they leaned into what made the characters decades-long successes. Change is good for story, but inevitably you need to touch base with what brought them. Gender swaps, sexual orientation changes, and outright changes to who's in the suit are short-term headline grabbers, but without long-term sales, with very few exceptions. Yeah, there have been a couple of cases where, you know, a swapped character has stuck, you know, but for the most part, it usually doesn't last. Tell stories without preaching. They want entertainment, not a serialized sermon. Limited new characters. Fresh blood is good, but it's become obvious that characters aren't organic to stories. They're shoehorned in for a bump in sales. Dance with who brung ya. I'd ask for a minimum advertised price, but we're not in that world anymore. You made deals with the devil, which is on you. Marvel and DC screwed this market, so if you want to continue to have people dumb enough to labor 60 hours a week for poverty wages to sell and advocate for your precious IPs, you need to invest in that market. Actual plans. So this is all retailer stuff. Look, I don't think it's salvageable. I'm going to be honest. I think it's comics will live on in some form. Manga is doing very well. Graphic novels are doing well. People who are good at crowdfunding, who have an audience, they will be fine. Okay. But like the other 95% of the comic book industry, the American comic book industry is screwed. So this is Jimmy Palmiotti, who's been in the industry for a very long time. He says it's on the nose. He said, ICV2 Comic Stores 2023. It's nearly 2024, and I'm more than concerned. He's saying, this guy, I guess, is saying that he only thinks there's like 2 years left of the direct market. And the pandemic definitely broke everything. I mean, it was already broken. It was kind of like duct taped together. And then when the pandemic happened and Steve Jeppy crawled under the desk in the fetal position and just wanted to shut down the comic book industry, it just, everything broke. So here comes Heidi McDonald. Retailers I've talked to think this is more on the butt. Two people I know used to shop at his store and complain they didn't get their pull list pulled. The issues he's talking about are real, but Marvel and Dynamite make variants because retailers buy them, not the reverse. This is Billy Flake, who is the host of the Coliseum Forum. So this is an employee of Coliseum of Comics. As the guy who orders the comics at Coliseum, I take umbrage with your claim that two people I know didn't get their pull list pulled. Like, shortages and damages never happen. That's like me saying two people I know think Comics Beat just regurgitates press releases. Oof. Fair enough. I was surprised at how many people complained about this, to be honest. Everyone talks about how pre-ordering is important, and not getting what you pre-ordered seems like yet another problem. This is Ryan Kelly. Artists, original work such as Local, Saucer, Country, Survivors Club. Licensed work includes Star Wars, Stranger Things, and Assassin's Apprentice. Okay. So, Heidi, I'm sorry, but I feel we all need to set aside the constant war against the bad people and be honest about the problems. Even so, going to battle with, I like heard maybe two people didn't get their comics once, is not the juicy data we need. Oh my God. I hear you. I will say this is not, oh, I heard blah, 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 but two people I know and trust who surprised me with their experience. I agree we should find the common ground. No, you do not. You do not. Heidi McDonald is, shockingly, part of a group on Facebook that basically gatekeeps the comic book industry. You know, and we're not talking like these are all like A-list comic book creators, but there's a bunch of people, you know, in and around the industry who are pretty damn good at gatekeeping comics, and they will smear you if they don't like you. Now, the weird thing is like her and Rich Johnson, I guess they don't get along very well at all. Like, you'd think they're all in cahoots together, but that's actually not the case. My understanding is that her and Rich do not have a very friendly rivalry. At least it's been my observation, but, yeah, I mean, it's going to affect you too. Comic book journalists, there's not going to be anything left to cover. Again, when you've got a YouTube channel out there, comic book YouTube channel, 3 million subscribers almost, saying that it's not viable to cover comics anymore because the general public has lost interest, it's over. It is over. And you helped usher it in by diverting people's attention away from those who would speak the truth because you didn't like them. You thought they were abrasive. You didn't like their politics. And maybe there were some people in some of those groups that were too abrasive and too political. That being said, you know, you can separate the message from the messenger. And the message is very clear. The American comic book industry is completely fucked. Again, Mark Miller has some good ideas. I don't think it's ever going to happen. I'm being honest. I think he's a smart guy, but I don't think it's ever going to happen. I think it's too late. I think guys like Todd McFarlane saw this decades ago and he's like, yeah, I'll do comics because I want to do comics, but I'm going to branch out into toys and get into some other stuff that does have a longer term future. And a lot of people, they're like, you know, asking like, what happened to so-and-so that used to work in comics in the 90s? What happened to this person and that person? You know, and a lot of them moved on to Hollywood. A lot of them moved on to video games because they saw the writing on the wall back then. You know, fast forward to 2023 and there's like nothing left. And the reason I think everybody is in everybody else's business and everybody is in everybody else's face all the freaking time is because you're fighting over scraps. You know, you're fighting over limited resources. There's not much left of comics. So the people that actually want to be part of the industry or want to keep control of the industry, they're just going to fight each other. You know, there's not enough food to go around. And it's really sad. It really is sad to see this happen. And it didn't have to be this way. It really didn't. Again, you look at how manga sales are doing in Japan, how like everybody reads comics in Japan. And like nobody cares over here. Superhero movies making $1 billion. At one point, we're definitely on the other side of that now, but nobody cares. And you had an opportunity when superhero movies were doing very, very well to course correct. And you didn't take it. Instead, you spent all the time attacking the YouTubers, attacking the chuds. Nuh-uh, sky's not falling, sky's not falling, sky's not falling. Well, it fell. It fell, guys. It's over. I don't know how many more comic book videos we're even going to do. I don't do very many of them because there's no point. I don't even know how many more comic book videos we're going to do because there's no point. I mean, there really is no point. It's like you're just beating a dead horse. Literally, you're beating a dead horse of an industry. It's like, oh, more crazy people are saying crazy things on Twitter about the crazy ass, broken, poverty stricken shell of a comic book industry. News at 11, who cares? Nobody cares. Everybody's moved on to other stuff. You know, and even the general public, the normies, given the box office of the Marvel and DC movies this year, yeah, they've moved on too. Everybody's moved on, except for these people that are going to, you know, grind their axe against YouTubers and shit for the next 10 years. You're going to be in the old folks' home complaining about the chuds on the internet. And people are going to be like, okay, grandma, take your pills. Sit down, watch Price is Right, okay? That's what's going to happen. And that's if any of these people can afford to even go to the old folks' home. Because the reality is that the money is not there. And a lot of these people are not even going to be able to afford to go to the old folks' home. And that's sad. It's just sad and depressing. Anyway, I don't want to be sad and depressed, so go buy our book. Thank you to those of you who have. We want to continue to make more books. We're just kind of gearing up. We don't need the direct market. We don't. We can make our books on our own terms, like so many other people are doing right now. And that actually is exciting. I don't want to spend a lot of time lamenting the death of the mainstream comic book industry because it has zero bearing on what we are doing. Going to wrap it up. Please subscribe for more pop culture news, views, and rants, guys. We'll talk later.